come back. Your dreams were your ticket out. Welcome back to that same old place.
I'm attorney Phil Jacino, and this is The Right Perspective here on WLINY.com, Long Island, New York, the world. I like that song, David Gates. That's from Welcome Back, Kotter.
That's right. It's all we had. The deck went down over here, so I only had that song up right now.
Normally, it's Ace Frehley.
That's right.
Back in the New York group.
And I wish it was so I could sing. So I'm sorry, Ed. It's not my fault.
Ed, are you on?
Where's the song? Can you hear me?
What, are you on in the bathtub underwater?
He's snorkeling. Ed.
Can you hear me?
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Oh, God. I can't take this.
You know what? I think it might be the Republicans. They're trying to silence. Yeah, I can hear you, Ed.
All right, I'm here.
Okay, we got you now. Now you're good. Now you're good.
You're good, Ed.
Go.
So tell us your complaints about Trump this week.
I was listening to Standing on Principle for a whole hour, and I kept waiting to hear about the health care bill. You didn't mention Trump that much. What's up with this health care bill?
Tell us about it. What's your take on it?
It's a mess. The Republicans are imploding. And, you know, I've spoken to a lot of people, a lot of Democrats down here, a lot of liberals that I know. They're just sitting back. They're loving this. There's not much more they could ask for. If this bill goes down, I think thus goes the Trump presidency.
I don't think it's going to go down. I think there's going to be some reconciliation.
It is going to go down. Well, first of all, you have a whole contingent of conservatives that are not going to support it. So it may go through the House. It's dead in the Senate. If this goes down, it makes President Trump look bad. That's what everybody ran on. He ran on repeal and replace Obamacare, and the biggest piece of legislation he can't deliver on.
Yeah, he hasn't failed on it yet. You know, I think word of its demise is greatly exaggerated, Ed.
I don't think it's going to fail. I think the Republicans are in for they better go behind closed doors. You know, I was listening to talk radio.
He's meeting with them
on the way home from work, and you know, the conservative voice down here in Atlanta was his name was Eric Erickson was talking that they got to work this out. Even Sean Hannity said it too. If the Republicans don't get this together, that was their platform, and I don't understand what were they doing for 8 years. That all you heard for 8 years is that how Obamacare was bad and how Obamacare was this, it was that. Obamacare was blamed for everything. And then you get all three branches of government, and there's no plan.
Look,
that's
Ed,
what I'm
Ed,
really frustrated
I agree.
About.
Ed, I agree with you. If ultimately they fail, yes, that's a big problem. I agree with you. I'm not writing that off yet. It's not a done deal. It's failure.
Okay, but here's the thing that I don't like about it. I voted for Trump. I voted for this. You know, a lot of the things he stands for. I shouldn't say everything. I support a lot of things he ran for, but I'm not seeing it. The health care bill, I'm going to have to pay more. I'm going to be 50 in a few years, so I'm going to have to pay more. People's premiums are going to go up. I thought there was a plan to make Obamacare better. The executive
that's the goal.
On immigration. Twice he put that through. That's failed. I'm not seeing successes with his presidency.
You've acted as judges. Ed, it should not have failed. Even Dershowitz. Look, Dershowitz is a liberal man. He's probably one of the best legal minds in this country. He said that judge was wrong. What Donald Trump did was constitutional. But you're always going to find a judge out there, in this case Hawaii, you're always going to find a judge out there that disagrees with Trump is going to try to shoot him down. So I don't put too much stock in that.
Okay. But we've got to see, there has to be some, you know, victories, you know, for the American public. I haven't seen anything yet. If they had the election today, I think if the election was done if they had another presidential election today, Clinton would win. I mean, it's just, this is not what a lot of people signed on for.
He's been in office, I think, a little less than 60 days. About 60 days.
What's that?
He's been in office for about 60 days. 2 months. Not a long time.
Right. And I wish he would stop tweeting. He's the president of the United States. His tweet about, I want some evidence. I think we need to hold him accountable for what he said about President Obama wiretapping Trump Tower. He has to be held accountable for things that he says.
What about, Ed, what about the, you there? Okay. What about the proof that the Russians hacked our election? Don't you want proof of that, too?
Okay. Well, we all know that's the media, the fake media. That issue is dead as of today. Now that they're coming for Bill Clinton made a speech for $500,000 in Russia, in Moscow. That's been released today. There's ties to the Clintons with the Russians. You're going to see that story die really quick. That's a done deal with all the information that's coming out. The Democrats are involved with the Russians just as much as the Republicans. I think that's a done deal. But look at the damage that story has done to the Trump presidency.
Right. And look, Obama didn't have the media against him like Trump does. So there was a honeymoon period for President Obama. There is not a honeymoon period for, if anything, they're talking about impeachment. The first day he got in, they were talking about impeachment. So how hard is it to deal with the Democrats when, like, Maxine Waters and Nancy Pelosi, they don't want this guy.
No.
And they'll do anything they can to hurt him.
But let's not give, 2018, give the House of Representatives Senate back to the Democrats.
Oh, God. God help us.
Well, but the way it's going, that could easily happen.
Steven,
you've got to have some successes in the White House.
Stephen Bell,
everyone.
One sec.
Quiet down. Stephen Bell says the health care bill was insolvent. Okay, I'm done.
Okay.
Okay, well, good job, Frank. I'm glad you read that correctly. The health care bill is a disaster. Let's just keep Obamacare.
That ain't going to happen because that's Obamacare, not where that's failing.
Okay, it's failing, but where is the replacement plan that the Republicans... You need to tell me. In 8 years, the Republicans couldn't sit in a room and iron out a plan that helped the American public. And I think one thing Trump said that today is right. If the Republicans don't get it together, they're going to lose their jobs. I just think everybody voted. A lot of people, Trump ran a great campaign. He screwed up, so many times, and people still backed him with, some of the things he's done and said, but people didn't care. They put him in office. Now we want to see some results.
That's right.
And I think the health care bill was, it's just the fact that it's not even being rolled out. It should have been one plan, everybody on board, and then you go up against the Democrats. You have half the Republicans that are against it with the Democrats. You're never going to get a Democratic vote on anything for the next 4 years. And I don't understand why the Republicans don't understand that.
But you got to understand something. When the Democrats passed the bill, all right, I'm sure there were Democrats that didn't agree with it, but they weren't going to say anything.
You had to pass the bill to read
listen,
it. Exactly.
And she had a lot of power back then, so she got everybody in line. A lot of these Republicans are independent thinkers, and I respect that. We could disagree. There are a lot of principled Republicans that say, I disagree with that.
Nancy Pelosi ran a tight ship. They stuck together. The Republicans are not sticking together.
That's my point. The Republicans are not sticking together because some of them just fundamentally disagree with the bill. And I respect that.
Well, that means nothing's going to get done. What about tax reform? You have this conservative there too.
Well, they're not
going to
get that till they get
the
American
public. What's that?
They're not going to go to tax relief until they get this thing done.
Hey, guys.
Yes.
Hey, guys.
Okay.
Everybody, you guys, you listen to The Right Perspective with Phil Jacino and Ed from Atlanta, Ed Vilbig. That's the guy you guys love to hate, by the way. And Steven says we need to stop thinking on federal levels. States can control this.
Well, that's part of what the bill is trying to do. And the Democrats who like a centralized government don't like it.
Well, okay, I agree with you. That's why a lot of people, Trump had a big electoral gain. He won the election. But now let's see something get done. This health care bill is not better for the American taxpayer than Obamacare.
Well, some people believe that it is.
They need to go back to the drawing board, and they need to make it work for all people.
That's not going to happen. They're not going to throw this whole thing out. They're going to tinker with it until they get a bill that they can get enough votes for. That's how it works in Washington.
I hope you're right. I really do. Otherwise, this is going to be a major disaster for the Republican Party. I don't think they're going to recover. 2018, they are going to get... If there's no replacement to Obamacare, I think 2018 will be a bloodbath. This could be the only time in history that we'll have a Republican president, two branches of Congress, and it'll only be 2 years.
Well, look, I think you and I agree that this is very, very big. And they got to pass a bill. The Republicans have to pass a bill. We just disagree. I say give them a little more time, and I'm not maybe as concerned as you are, because you're looking at this as, look, they've been in office for two. He's been in office 2 months. Why didn't he solve the world's problems? Give him a little more time.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that before, when they were running, when they were running for election, and they're standing, you know, with their constituency, they're talking about, we got to get rid of Obamacare, repeal, replace it, and everybody believed that, and they win the election, and there's no plan. That's what I have a problem with, and I just hope that this is not the trend for the next 3.5 years of everything. Something comes up,
I'm going to speculate a little bit.
Hold on one second. I just have this. I have a problem with Paul Ryan, the way he's running the Republican Party. If you're going to let the far right derail the agenda of the Trump administration, then you're going to have, like, tax reform. Is Rand Paul going to get up there and say, this doesn't go far enough, the tax cuts? Every time something comes about, you've got to get...
He doesn't want that to happen, but it's happening. Paul Ryan doesn't want the far right to hijack the Republican Party, but there's a faction that he has to deal with. Now, I wanted to say this. I'm going to speculate a little bit. You had a question. You said, why didn't the Republicans really think this through a little bit more? I think part of it was they never thought there would be a Republican in office as president. I really do believe
that. Well, there is.
Maybe they didn't think that was going to happen, so they said, if Hillary gets in, guess what? We're never going to repeal Obamacare.
Guys, everybody listening on all website, everywhere you're listening from, call in number.
Sure.
They're asking. Call in number is 1-888-583-9930.
Isn't it extension 100?
Yes, I was just going to say that.
Okay.
Extension 100. One more time, 888-583-9930. 30.
Isn't it extension 100?
Extension 100. I'll put this in the chat room, actually.
Frank, you are doing a great job as an engineer. I think your engineer skills are better than your talk show skills.
Wow.
He warms up for our show, the second show, better than the first show.
I found your outro. I found your outro song, by the way.
Okay, Hawaii 5-0.
Yeah. I'm just kidding, Frank. You know that.
We got to appease Vilbig a little bit with that outro song.
Okay, let's get back to politics here, because I have all these notes. I jotted down these notes. And okay, about the tweeting thing. If the president of the United States gets out there and makes a false statement,
a statement that hasn't been backed up yet. We to call it false could be, but maybe that's what he believed. I'm not saying he should have tweeted it, but that's what he believes. And you can't say it's false.
Okay, what I don't understand, there's a lot of people out there that agree with his platform. When he was running for president, that's why they voted. They stood by him, even with some of the crazy things he said. They forgave him. They went to the ballot box and they voted for him. Why is this infatuation with tweeting every time somebody, like Meryl Streep, and every time somebody, even with Colin Kaepernick? That is, he needs to. I really think he needs to stop.
Did you see him speak in Kentucky? Did you see him speak in Kentucky the other day?
Yes.
That place was packed.
Did he say Colin Kaepernick?
Apparently, Trump tweeted about him.
Oh,
he mentioned him at the
about him, spoke about him at the rally. Here's the thing: Trump is basically talking, tweets or talks about people at rallies. He doesn't need to do that. I don't support what Colin Kaepernick did. Of course, I don't support
that. He's playing to his base, Ed.
They
love him.
I don't want the president.
Tammy says it keeps us in the loop.
Right. He's transparent, Ed.
I don't want the president. I don't want the president of the United States tweeting out about the ratings of Celebrity Apprentice. Or every time somebody insults it, like I get the tweets. I get up in the morning, there's 3 or 4 tweets. I don't think he should. I think he should be focused on tax reform, health care. The health care.
Ed, he's multitasking. He's multitasking. He can do it.
Ed, it's kind of like he's being transparent. Kind of like when you open up your blinds and walk through your living room naked. You're just being transparent. Just like Trump.
Okay. There we go again. And his family.
Frank, get your mind out of the gutter.
Some of my family is listening.
I told you.
At the next meeting.
His parents are listening. Come on.
Sorry,
we need
Mr.
to address, yeah, we need to address at the next meeting. And because I have what I have to deal with at 9 o'clock, I think I'm entitled to an increase in pay. I've been fighting for months, and I still
we're
going to
multiply your salary by 100, Frank. How about that? We're going to multiply his salary. And you're a mathematician, right, Frank?
Yeah.
So, well, what's 0 times 100? Okay. <good. laughs>
Anyway, back to the tweeting thing. I wish Trump would just focus on the big picture and not go after people that are just regular citizens. I mean, although they could be athletes, they could be actresses or actors. I don't want them dealing with Hollywood. I want them working on my healthcare bill. I want them working on tax, immigration. I want them working on really education in this country is a mess. In 2 weeks, I'm going to be on vacation. Dr. Leroy Sublett's going to fill in for me. He's going to talk about education with you guys. It's a mess.
Dude, you have more vacations.
This is him. We need to work hard. We need to get our roll up our sleeves. I'm going to be away for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
But when I come back.
Jeez, you do more flying around than, I'm not kidding, than anybody.
What does your Amex look like?
I know what his Amex doesn't say. It doesn't say Carvel because he wouldn't pay for the ice cream when he was over here. He's too busy flying around. You can't. Jeez.
Yeah, it's spring break, though. I'm in the education system. What I see, I dare both of you to come down here and spend one day, and I'll take it around some schools because I visit a lot of schools.
You will have to pay.
You will be in shock. You will be really.
I don't know. I work with some pretty rundown things, but I don't know.
This country's got some serious issues we're going to have to deal with. And that's my point. I don't want my president tweeting out stuff that's really irrelevant when you have schools where you have thousands of kids that are not getting an education, that are dropping out, that are in crime and drugs. And
well, let me ask you,
stuff going on.
Ed, let me ask you this. All right, you know I'm on Facebook often, correct? And I know, and I know you're on Facebook.
He bills his clients for that.
It's billable time. And I know you're on Facebook, Ed. Maybe not as prolific as I am, but you're on Facebook. Does that mean that you can't be on Facebook and also be an excellent administrator, or that I can't be an excellent attorney, just because when I have a little downtime, I decide to send out a Facebook post?
No, of course not. And what was that word you used? Prolific? That's a big word. What is that?
Prolific.
Frank doesn't understand, so make sure. Frank, what's that word mean?
No, that's not true. He's looking it up, Ed. Give him a little credit.
You know what? Let me chime in for a second. I kind of don't, and it's not that I'm trying to get a word in those people, because you guys are insulting some people. I can't get a word in. It's not my show, though. I'm not supposed to get a word in, so I'll defend them for that much.
Get the word in. Go ahead.
So let me get my word in.
We listen to the V-Train. We get tortured every Thursday on the V-Train.
Okay. All right. So anyway, I'm going to get my 2 cents into the Right Perspective show. I kind of don't like. He could peel it back some, like when he was like saying how Schwarzenegger doesn't have the ratings for, like, who cares, man? Don't you have to tweet about that? For the most part, I don't care that he tweets either. Tweet away, but stuff like that, it's like, you know, who cares? You don't need to do that.
I'll grant you that. If he could cut down the tweets and only talk about like the fake news thing, I do like when he puts out his tweet and he'll say fake news, and every time he says fake news, it's right, basically. Even this whole, I guarantee you're going to see the Russia story disappear. Now that it came out that the Democrats are in collusion with the Russians also.
They both parties should drop it.
Will go away.
Anthony says he's human.
But,
that's right.
I'm only human.
Yeah. Good song.
Frank, you could sing on your show, not on this show, please.
Wow.
We have high ratings here. But I agree. If he could just stick to the facts and not the Celebrity Apprentice tweets, I think that'd be a step in the right direction. I'd like to know when he does these tweets, if anybody like reads them before. I find that one tweet about the Obama administration really troubling. He can't do something like that again.
Like
he'll
what?
Get a pass on this one, I think.
No, that they wiretapped him his tower.
You think they did wiretap him, Phil?
No.
No, I asked what.
I don't know if it's so much of a wiretap. Maybe some people in the administration did something. I don't know. Look, and if there's no proof, then he should drop it.
But time out. There's three prongs to the story. There's the wiretap, right? That they love to say how Trump is wrong. Okay, and then there's the collusion with the Russians that there was no proof ever in like 7-8 months now. Not one document to prove it. But how about the third thing? These people running their mouths and getting and letting loose the top secret information with Flynn.
Yeah, somebody got that information.
That's a crime.
Okay, those are crimes. Those are crimes.
But they're not paying attention to that. Somebody needs to investigate that and exploit that.
You're right. The media, the media has so many double standards. We all know that. The American public knows that. So really what the American public, we know that even the American public doesn't even listen to the media anymore. When I turn on Good Morning America in the morning, it is a joke. It is 95% slanted towards Democrats.
You mean
Channel 7.
See, Phil was wrong. Phil told me before the show that you turned it on at night, Good Morning America, and you can never find it. But you just said you did turn it on. You confirmed you did turn on
TiVo
in the morning, Good Morning America. So good. Good job.
Yeah, it goes on at 7 to 9 here in Atlanta. But anyway, the thing is, here's the big picture. Trump, the Russian story we know is untrue. The Russians did not hack the voting machines. That's all there is to it. Drop it. However, the damage is done. Trump's popularity is 37%. All these stories, the media keeps hammering away. And then when he makes a statement that's untrue, it's just fuel to the fire.
You know what? That's
what he has to think about.
Understanding our principle, Frank started it and I picked up on it. How about people follow the rules? This is what I'm going to say. How about people in positions of power, whether they be president, speaker of the House, Congress, whatever, congressman, why don't they only come forward and make an allegation if they can back it up? And that goes for Trump, right? If everybody did that, you wouldn't have people speculating to the point of ridiculousness. You want to make an allegation?
Well, it's not going to happen because the Democrats have not gotten over that they didn't lose. They got slaughtered, but they lost. If he would have just won the presidency and the Democrats would have held on to the Senate, and it would have been a different thing. They lost all branches of government.
Republicans have a mandate. They have a mandate.
They lost 1,000 seats, and I was part of that. I voted for him, but I am not happy with the results, the way he's running his presidency. You turn on Good Morning America, and it's just he gets hammered. Some of these stories are fake, but some of them are not fake. And then when you have him making statements, every time he tweets, the tweets are twisted to make him look like he's a crazy man.
Look, if he...
That's what I don't like about it.
If Trump cured cancer tomorrow, they would criticize him in some way. He's cheating death. They would find something to attack him. And he's smart enough to know he's never going to win over certain Democrats. He's playing to his base because it worked in the election. The Democrats didn't like him. Independents voted for him, but the Democrats didn't like
him. Somebody's trying to call in. I'm not ignoring you. I'm not ignoring you, caller. I can't pick up the phone right now. I'm sorry.
Oh, because we have Ed from Atlanta.
I'm sorry. Next time.
Go to the chat room.
Sorry about that.
If you try to call in, go to the chat room.
Somebody's saying, Anthony's saying that this guy, I think this guy refers to you, Ed. I don't know what this means. This guy needs a little Spumoni Garden pizza. What's Spumoni Garden? Is that a restaurant?
I don't know.
I love pizza.
What the hell?
Anytime you want a pizza, the next time I come to New York, you guys got to take me out.
Wait, he's never paid yet.
He owes.
You've never paid yet.
You're getting top-notch talent budget.
Everybody, if you ever seen Ed from Atlanta in person, his arms, they don't go lower than his waist, his belt. They stop at his belt.
They don't reach into his
they
pocket.
They never reach his pocket. No question. Never. They don't reach. No, he can't help it.
I'm on a fixed income. And living on a fixed income is tough. I got spring break in 2 weeks. I got to save.
He's going on another cruise or whatever.
The restaurants and pizza, Anthony says.
Yeah, exactly. But spring break here is... when do you guys have spring break up there?
April sometime.
My niece is back from college right now, actually.
Oh, okay. Everybody...
That's college. Yeah.
Our spring break is the first week in April. And today it was 80 degrees. This is how the weather fluctuates down here. It was 80 degrees. It was a beautiful day. And then on Thursday, it's going to be 55 and cold and rainy.
In Atlanta?
So, yes.
Wow.
So today, 80. Thursday, it'll be 55. Weather goes up and down. That's what everybody...
It's global warming.
Ed, I got a question for you. How do you feel now that Brady's jerseys were found in Mexico? You happy about that?
Well, I'm glad they found the jersey. But that's what I'm trying. I want Trump to fix immigration, build that wall, and restore dignity in this country to, you know, the, what, you know, what you've been doing on that front. I like that. Dignity to the United States around the world. I am for all, some of those policies, and so is most of America. But when he wanders off, when he goes off course, he gets himself in serious trouble. He needs to stop with the tweeting and focus on that healthcare bill, because his presidency, I'll speculate, his presidency is going to depend on this healthcare bill, immigration, and the tax, the tax reform. If he goes 0 for 3 on the, out of those three topics, it's 2018 will be a disaster. Right.
And look,
if he comes through, if they fix healthcare and it works, if the tax bill lowers the tax burden for the American middle class, and he fixes immigration and he restores the military and gives veterans, you know, their fair share of good, you know, healthcare and coverage, the Democrats will be obliterated in 2018.
Tammy says that Trump knows exactly what he's doing. Don't worry.
I'm still with him. And Ed, I think you got to give him a little more patience.
Most people that are intelligent are with Trump. The people that are wanting to fail because some of the people I know that are so liberal, so left, people that are very left want the country to go downhill so that the Democrats can get back in.
Stevens.
Then you have the right, which is so far where the right wingers want to just throw everybody off, you know, like end all benefits for everything, and the rich have everything. So we got to find the middle ground, and that's what I think Trump is trying to do. But he's getting
Stephen
hit
says
from all fronts. Yeah.
Stephen says that Trump has a war coming,
a war
like an actual literal war.
He's in one with the Democrats. The Democrats will not. There's not. I like the Supreme Court. I like the way he answered those questions, Gorsuch. I like the way he answered some of those questions, and he was attacked by Schumer. And
he's going to get in.
On.
No question, he'll get in.
Who?
Gorsuch.
I like the guy, but everything is going to be battled with the Democrats. And here's the thing, Gorsuch, he'll get in, and there's probably going to be if Trump stays in. Let's say the Republicans, or let's say Trump doesn't run in 3.5 years, and someone else, and he decides he doesn't want to run. But if the Republicans stay in power, they'll have the whole Supreme Court in a few years.
Right.
But so they can't give up the White House in the next election. They can't do it.
Well, look, Ginsburg, no way can she last. If he gets elected again, I don't even think she'll last this term, Ginsburg.
I don't think she's going to last. But the Republicans could end up having 2 or 3 Supreme Court nominations in the next 3 years. And then after that, the next 4 years, the whole Supreme Court could go conservative, or I don't even want to say the word conservative. I just want to. I want the court to go to the middle, to serve the middle class. Too far left is no good, and too far right.
Well, look, here's a novel idea. Interpret this. Follow the Constitution.
No,
that's all you got to do.
What are you talking about? Follow the Constitution.
I'm saying a Supreme Court judge.
I'm really concerned.
They're not activists.
I'm really concerned about this. I'm sorry.
They have to follow the Constitution. Their job is not to make law. A judge.
Well, you can see what goes on, how judges act now. But the thing is, I'm concerned, real concerned with this freedom, what do they call it, the Freedom Caucus, these far-right wingers. They could derail the whole Republican Party and derail Trump's presidency if they don't get them under control. Paul Ryan has to do what Nancy Pelosi did with the Democrats. You vote for the bill, then we'll see what's in it. That was such a crazy statement, but it worked. The Republicans have got to do the same thing.
The Republicans are not following that stupid strategy. The Republicans that are not following that stupid Pelosi strategy.
I believe if health care fails, and then and they do the same thing with tax reform, and they do the same thing with other issues that come about in this country, and nothing gets done, you will see the Democrats take control in 2018.
Ed, that's a big if. A big if.
But I'm saying if he can get those three things done on his agenda, health care, tax reform, immigration, there'll be nothing. It could be a Reagan election back in 1984.
Right.
It was a landslide. I remember that night the election was over by 8 o'clock. It was just everybody, the whole
only state that Mondale won?
Right. But that's my point.
Minnesota.
If the Republicans can get it together and help the American people, the people in Wisconsin, the people in Pennsylvania, Michigan, those states that turned blue, that went from blue to red, that went for Trump, if he can help them, the Republicans will stay in power. But if they start this, if they start losing major battles, because the media is against them. There's two things you got to remember here. The media is totally against Trump and the judicial branch. So he has got an uphill battle. He can't be fighting his own party, which are the Republicans.
Right. But, Ed, the economy is going to be the most – health care is important. The economy is the most important thing. If you don't have a job, you're not going to vote for this guy again. If you have a job, you're more likely to vote for him. And he knows that. It's the remember Carville? It's the economy, stupid. He came out and he said that.
You're right about that.
During Clinton's years. It's the economy that's the most important thing. Health care is up there, no question. Ed, we're going to have to –
Mr. Frank Vetro, the star – can I ask Mr. Frank Vetro a question, the star of the V-Train, that everybody – that's the number one internet program on Thursday?
Oh, yeah.
He wants something from you now.
Yeah, I just – listen, I don't speak during the show, remember? I just make sure you guys can be heard. But what do you got?
Okay, can we Skype next week? Because this is very difficult with just doing this phone thing with this Bluetooth.
Wait a second. You mean I gotta listen and see your face?
That's asking for a lot.
Jesus.
No, not even that. Can we just do the voice on Skype? Because it's much better in my.
We'll take it under advisement.
All right, everybody, Ed wants you to see his face. He wants to prove to you that his arms do reach his pockets.
No.
Ed, why don't you tell everybody? Listen, Ed, why don't you tell everybody? You never do. I'm going to give you a little shout out here. Why don't you tell all your loyal listeners? You're like J.R. Ewing. You're the person they love to hate. All right. So why don't you tell them how to reach you? Facebook, Twitter. Where can they find you?
On a cruise.
Well, that's on a cruise. Also, this time I won't be able to call in. So I have a great guest for you. He's been on the show already, and he is very educated. He's a doctor of education, and he will fill in for me 2 weeks from tonight. And I'm sure that you'll get some phone calls. It'll be great. Mm-hmm. But if you want to reach me, just contact WLINY.com, and I'd be more than happy to respond.
Well, you're on Facebook, Ed.
Yeah, look me up on Facebook.
That's what I'm talking about, Ed Vilbig. Jesus, Ed Vilbig. Everybody, V-I-L-B-I-G, Ed Vilbig.
M-O-U-S-E.
I post things. I repost a lot of what Phil says. Some things I disagree with, but I agree with a lot of things he does say. I am just not, and people that know me, and I take both sides with many. I am in the middle. I am not a liberal, I am not a conservative.
It goes both ways. We heard it.
You heard it, everybody. He goes both ways.
I am a taxpayer. And I look at each individual issue, and I just don't go into the voting booth and push Republican or Democrat. I voted for Obama the first time. George Bush was not doing a good job in his second term. I went with Obama. But with this election, I went with Trump. I want to see the resurgence of the American taxpayer. That's what I want to see.
Good. And on that, we're going to have to leave it there. Everybody, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Join us next week at 8 o'clock for Standing
Good Up. Good night, everybody. Good night, Atlanta.
Okay. I'll be with Ed Vilbig, with Frank Vetro at 8 o'clock.
Frank, roll the music, please.
We got
it. At 9 o'clock, The Right Perspective. Good night, everybody.
Book 'em, Dano. Murder 1.
Book 'em, Dano.
Can we get some music?
Wow.
Yeah.
Too soon.
Good night, everybody.